Welcome back to the literature session, dear children. Due to the present condition of the country, we are not in a position to conduct the live sessions. So that's why we just hope to meet in this kind of video lessons. Okay. Now, today we are going to discuss about just a new poem. You know, dear children, now we have covered up the second term syllabus of the grade 10. So now let's move on to the third term syllabus. Now I have selected the poem Once Upon a Time by Gabriel O'Hara. Right? Once Upon a Time. Dear children, please look at the title very carefully. Okay. Once upon a time, once, there must be capital, upon, you must be capital, time, T must be capital. And the name of the poet, Gabriel O'Hara, I don't think that you may find any kind of difficulty in writing this. The spellings of the name of the poet, no worries. Okay. Gabriel O'Hara. This is the poet, right? He's a Nigerian poet. You know, he's from Africa, right? So, once upon a time, son, they used to laugh with their hearts and laugh with their eyes. So, dear children, when we just read the title and even the first line, what kind of feeling do you get regarding the poem? I think this phrase must be very much familiar to you since your childhood, right? Once upon a time, there was a, right, like that. So, that is the common phrase that is used to begin a fairy tale. So we get that kind of idea that we are going to discuss, we are going to deal, we are going to read some kind of a fairy tale. So that idea may come into your mind when you just read the title. But let's see, let's go in deep into the poem and see whether this is really a fairy tale or not. Once upon a time, son, they used to laugh with their hearts and laugh with their eyes. So it is going to be completely a different story rather than a fairy tale. They used to laugh with that past tense verb. We may find that it is, he's referring to the time in the past. They used. So what does this they refer to? They used to laugh. So then they here, the pronoun they refers to the people in the ancient time. The people who belong to the old age. Right? That means the ancient time, ancient era. The earlier generations people. They used to laugh with their hearts and laugh with their eyes. හදවතට එකඟවනවන් කොම hina වෙනකොට පුතේ නේද ඒ හදවතට එන සතුට definitely it reflects through your eyes so we can the people around you can identify whether you are laughing whether you are smiling heartiestly or true heartedly or not අවංකවම හදවතින්ම එකඟව hina වෙනවද නැද්ද කියන එක පුතේ ඔයාගේ ඇස් දෙක දිහා දැක්කම facial expressions so once upon a time san ekamatthika kalaka pute e kala hitupu minissu hinawune meema so that gives us a hint that the poet is going to compare that old age people and their laughter with the modern type of people and the people who belongs to this modern era and it suggests we seem that it's quite contrasting. So the poet is going to deal with some kind of contrasting idea. So definitely it's obvious that we are not going to talk about fairy tale anymore, right? They used to laugh with their hearts. So that laughter was really, really natural and genuine, dear children. ඉහිනව තව කෙනෙක්ට sarcastically idea එකක් තියාගෙන hina වෙච්ච දෙයක් නෙවෙයි. True heartedly, honestly, genuinely ආපු hinawak. That laughter was quite natural. හිතේ එකක් තියාගෙන hina වෙච්ච hinawak නෙවෙයි ඒ කාලේ මිනිස්සුන්ට තිබුණේ. So actually when we laugh wholeheartedly with true feelings, it is reflected on our eyes. So that is the genuineness of the people. That is the genuine laughter they had in earlier times. Right? Now, let's see these pictures, dear children. This lady, she's definitely laughing with her fullest heart. Right? You can see the happiness that comes out through her eyes even. And look at this little baby. Very cute and innocent. You can see the happiness of this baby, and you can see her happiness is obviously reflected in her eyes. So that is the real laughter. That is the natural laughter, right? So let's see. So I have here, dear children, I have separated your whole stanza into two, just to show you the comparison and the contrast the poet is going to show us, right? But now, what is the next line? But now they only laugh with their teeth. හැබැයි දැන් ඒගොල්ලෝ hina වෙන්නේ දත් පෙන්නලා විතරයි. While their eyes block cold eyes search behind my shadow. What is it? Now, dear children, what does the pronoun they here refer? මෙතනදී but now he is referring to definitely the modern society at present. So surely this they represents, the pronoun they represents the people in the modern society. So they only laugh with their teeth. ඒමිනි අද කාලේ මිනිස්සු hina වෙන්නේ දත් පෙන්නලා විතරයි. That laughter is not natural. They are not laughing true heartedly. They have no any kind of genuine emotion or genuine feeling. So their laughter is completely a fake one. Other than the laughter they had in the bygone era. Right? So now laugh with their teeth. So actually, the very negative idea is created here. Right? So ice block cold ice. What do you mean by this? That is a compound word, and also you can take it as a metaphor. While they are ice block cold ice, cold and ice, actually it suggests that no warmth in that laughter. Something is blocked. Block keken kiyanne puthe. Some kind of negative ideas are blocked in their eyes, and also they already have become like objects, like blocks. So there are several interpretations, several meanings regarding this metaphor, ice block cold ice. So actually the poet wants to say that the people have become emotionless and like objects or like blocks, right, in their behavioral pattern, especially in their laughter. So when they laugh, they are not laughing genuinely. That is the idea. So cold here also, you know, dear children, it emphasizes that they feel no warmth and love. And even the eyes also the same, the word eyes, right? People have blocked their true identity even. And personality traits, their true feelings and opinions are unknown. හරියට පුතේ අර අපි පාට කන්නඩියක් දාගෙන ලෝකේ බලනකොට ඒ පාටින් තමයි අපිට ලෝකේ පෙනෙන්නේ. So that kind of ideas, the negative ideas are flocked in their eyes, and with that kind of negative impressions they'll laugh with others. So then that laughter may not be genuine and natural. So that laughter is really fake and always harmful and poisonous maybe. And also, while they are laughing at present, they search behind my shadow. What are they searching for? They look for something that they can use against this person, or else that whether I can gain some benefits from this person behind my shadow. Mage hevanallata piripasse thiyena de thamai hoyanne. So what is the use of finding such kind of personal things and all? So if we come across a man and if we laugh with a man, so that we don't find any kind of discriminations and barriers in our, even to laugh with other people. So we laugh with the people because they are humans even. To create laughter, to create a smile, to have a genuine laughter, that to know that this is also a man, it's a human, that reason is totally enough. But here at present, මේ පුතේ තමන් ඉස්සරහට එවෙලා එන මිනිස්සයාට හිනාවකින් සංග්‍රහ කරන්න බැරි නම් අපේ මනසකම කොහෙද තියෙන්නේ? අපිට හිනා වෙන්න ඒ මිනිස්සයාගේ වගතුග හොයන්න ඕනේද? ආ? Do we need to find out whether this man is a poor one, whether this man is a rich one, wealthy one, able one, affluent one, or whether he is a very good, kind-hearted one or a bad one? No, nothing. Only the feeling, only the reason of humanity should be there to make and to create a laughter with a man. Manusyek kahina vedite vediya deyak konada daruwane. But here the poet makes contrast with the past people of the past, and here he has taken only one aspect of people, that is the laughter. He says that in the past, in the ancient times, people laughed genuinely. Their true laughter was there. But now, people have become totally negative, and they are driven by false values in the society. So even their laughter is poisonous and fake. It's really harmful laughter that come out from the people's faces. They need to know the background details of the people, even to laugh with them. So what is the use of humanity? What is the validity of being a man if we cannot just have a simple, genuine laughter with the other people? Right? Can you see this picture, dear children? I think this laughter, this is a real, the most suitable picture for this idea. You can see that portrait is separated into two, and that is in one part it seems she is smiling, and the other part you can see that she has a grin on her face. That means it's really a sarcastic smile is there. So that in a way it's really, no, it is completely not a genuine laughter, right? Shall we compare the laughter of these two people, right? And just you can have a look on this one also. True happiness thiyenne kotanada kiyala danenawada puthe? Right? True heartedly, out of the bottom of the heart. Who is laughing here? Is this lady or the previous one? Of course, the previous one. That's why I tell you. Can you see the difference between these two people's laughter? Me pudgalayun dedanage hinawal deka contrast, compare and contrast karanna puluwanda puthe? Definitely we can. You see obviously that the previous picture, the woman in the previous picture, definitely laughing with bottom of her heart. That is her natural laughter. That is the genuine laughter. But here, you can see it's really poisonous. It's really harmful laughter is there with this lady. So it seems that the writer, the poet is, what the poet going to say is definitely a true one. So, me as well reflect on what the true happiness is. No. So, actually, this is not a genuine smile. or a genuine laughter. So then that's why they only lie. He says, the Okara says that they only laugh with their teeth. ඔයක පුතේ විරිත්ති ඉල්ලක් වගේ නේ අපිට පේන්නේ. මේක laughter එකක් නෙවෙයිනේ. විරිත්තනා වගේ. ඒක කොච්චර effect වෙනවද දකින්න කෙනෙකුට. So that's why the poet says he takes one aspect of a people's characteristics and he contrasts the two different eras and the two different laughters in the two societies, right? He emphasizes that the laughter he had seen in the past with the past people is really, really genuine, and that laughter with the modern people are completely fake, right? Shall we move on to the next stanza? Before that, here there's another picture, of course, which shows that artificial smiling. You can see that the lady does not have any kind of emotions in her eyes, but only her teeth is showing laughter. So is this the genuine laughter of this lady? No. So poet says this is the common thing for all. අද සමාජයේ මිනිස්සු හැමෝම එහෙමයි. So they don't have any kind of true emotions, true hearted, honest and frank emotions in their hearts, but they only show teeth, pretending then that they are just laughing. So it's, we cannot say that it is a genuine laughter. Actually, it's fake, right? There was a time indeed they used to shake hands with their hearts. Now in the first stanza he had taken the laughter, and now he has taken the ritual of handshaking. You know that ritual of handshaking is the welcoming gesture of European people, right? They used to shake hands. Again he goes back to the bygone past. They used to shake hands with their hearts, but that's gone, son. ඒ කාලේ මිනිස්සු පුතේ shake hand කරේ, එකිනෙකව හඳුනගත්තේ, welcome කරේ heartiestlyමයි, හදවතට එකඟවමයි. නමුත් ඒ කාලේ දැන් ගිහිල්ලා පුතේ, that is gone, son කියලා කියනවා. There was a time. එහෙමත් කාලයක් තිබුණා. You know that this gesture, right? It should be really genuine, and there are some kind of rituals bound with this handshaking custom, right? You have to have eye contact with them, with the person you are handshaking, right? So you can just talk just a little bit. Introduction must be given, right, when you are doing handshake. But so that were there with the people in the past. E kala minissu gawa eka thibuna daruwane, which we are lacking today. අපි අත අදදි අත කෙනෙකුට දීලා ටග්ගාලා අත ඇදලා අරගෙන අපි වෙන වැඩක් කරනවා වෙන කතාවක් අපිට that suggest completely it's like an insult to the other person. සමහරට තව කෙනෙක් එක්ක කතා කර කර තව කෙනෙක් එක්කට shake hand කරනවා. එතකොට එතන තියෙනවද පුතේ true hearted welcoming එක? අර එනකොටම ටග්ගාලා මුණ ගැසලා අහග බලාගත්තා වගේ වැඩක්. And I think you may have seen in the television also that the foreigners, they are shaking hands for a while. Even ata deela atagat atadunu gaman atagan eka neve shake hand kiyanne e ata shake kar kar poddak that they spend a while, even while they are doing handshaking, just to exchange some kind of ideas, just to exchange warmth and love. But that is all that were happened in the past, but not today, right? That is gone, son. We can see that the person, the man is addressing to the son, right? Obviously this must be an elderly person, it must be a father or a grandparent or whatever. It seems he should be an adult, an elderly one, and he is addressing to one of a younger child, right? But here you can see, although he addresses the sun does not reply. Right? Sun reply ekak dena bawak peinda na. So that's why we say it becomes a monologue even. Monologue, I think and I hope you may have known this word, monologue kiyana wacana taniyama kiyawana deya. Taniyama katha kirimak tamai puthe monologue kiyala api kiyanne. So here in this poem we can see this is a monologue, right? Mokada thatta ho elderly kenek vitarai puthe throughout the poem. Only one the speaker is speaking and no reply is given from the side of the sun. But it is obviously for sure the elderly man is addressing young one, right? So the second, as the second feature, he has taken the handshaking custom to compare and contrast the past era and the present world, right? Now, in contrast to the present genuine handshaking custom, now they shake hands without hearts. Then minister shake hand karane puthe hadagathak athuwa nevey. While their left hands search my empty pockets. Shake hand karana asse mage left hands monawada hoyanne empty pockets hoyenawa. What do you mean by these empty pockets? Actually they are searching for the status, especially the economic status. එකතකින් දකුණු අතින් shake hand කරලා වම් අතින් මගේ pockets හොයනවා කියන්නේ right they search whether the man is rich or poor so that means that suggests all kind of relationships are measured in terms of how much money or power that man has so everything every relationship every bond is going to be measured in that way So that is the money and the power has become the sole measurement of each and every bond, right? If this man is a very powerful figure in the society, that handshaking custom will be going to be a genuine one, but pretentious. If this man is totally a poor and helpless man, definitely that man is not welcomed. Right, so that's why it says the poet says while their left hand search my empty pockets right so people are fake actually and just seek only the gainings gains tamanta labenna thiyenawa nan deyak eka ganna vitarak so actually they are wearing completely a false mask Isn't that so, children? The minister face mask ekak me daagena inne. E asse wagathuga hoyaagena mage pocket search karagena pocket ekak adala ganwa kiyana eka nevi. Eken suggest karanne darone. That means the people are searching behind something. Right? Even they are searching behind my shadow. Right? So they are the fake behavior of modern people are obviously brought forward. By the poet with these shake hand custom right empty pockets if these pockets are filled with money that person will be welcomed actually these pockets are empty there will be no more any kind of bond with them kisima bond ekak athi karaganna soodanamak nae එතකොට මේ බර පොකට් එක දිහා බලලා තමයි හැම බොන්ඩ් එකකටම ඩිසිෂන් එකක් එන්නේ. ඒ හෑන්ඩ් ෂේකින් කස්ටම් එක ජෙනුයින්ද නැද්ද වෙන්නේ යන්නේ එතකොට තමයි. So is that the validity of humanity dear children? ඒකද මනුස්සකමේ වැදගත්කම? So now obviously you can see this elderly person is totally torn between these two generations and the two societies. අපිත් පුතේ මෙහෙම ඉන්නේ because we all belong to this modern era we have not seen even such kind of serenity right such kind of genuineness we have not experienced such kind of natural and genuine feelings from the past. So we only have seen only the people, fake behavior of people in the present. So that's why we also tend to act and behave in that way. සුන්දරත්වය කියන එක අත්විඳලා තිබිච්ච මනුස්සයෙකුට පුතේ මේක විඳින්න අමාරුයි. මේ duality කියන එක, that hypocrisy of people කියන එක. Right? මේක හරි අමාරුයි පුතේ tolerate කරන්න. So that's why he tend to compare past and the present. Right? The poet has taken a very simple behavioral patterns to compare and contrast. Right? So when a person is introduced and greeted by handshaking, he or she is trying to find out the pockets. That means the financial and the economical status of this man. So it suggests that everything, every bond is measured out of money. So people at present are completely money oriented. Right? They only value money and all. So nothing else. True heartedness, genuineness. The problem is this elderly man or the father had seen and had touched and experienced all those genuine values in the past. But unfortunately, he does not find any kind of genuineness in this modern society. So he is really torn between these two types of societies. Make a tolerate karaganna bahe. So that's why he is revealing his inner confusion towards the sun. So he is addressing a kind of young boy and he is revealing his inner confusion. Of course, yes. Right. Feel at home. He shows us another incident. Feel at home. Come again. They say. අනේ ගෙදර වගේ ඉන්න ගෙදරකට විසිට් එකකට ගියාම කාගේ හරි ගෙදරකට විසිට් එකකට ගියාම දරුවනේ අනේ ඔයා ගෙදර වගේ ඉන්න කිසි ප්‍රශ්නයක් නැහැ ඕන දෙයක් බලන්න පුතේ එහෙම කියනවා එතකොට එන්න ලෑස්ති වෙදි කම්මගේ නනේ ආයෙත් එන්න අපි හරීම කැමති ඔයගොල්ලෝ එනවා නම් ඔයයි ඩිමාන්ඩ් තියෙන වෙලාවක ඕන වෙලාවක තෙන්ද ඕල්වේස් ද ඩෝස් ආ ඕපන් ටු යූ සෝ such kind of flowery words are uttered. They say egolo hemai kiyanne. And when I come again and feel at home, first thing oya puthe ane aa enna kiyala e wage ara balakirimak karana kota positive influence ekana denne just to visit back kiyana deeta. Ane ithin ape me taatta me father th yanawa. Second time also he visits that place and feel at home. Oh. සල්ලා වගේම බොහොම සාදරයෙන් පිළි අරගෙන with treatments and all once එකපාරක් එයිමයි twice දෙවෙනි පාරත් එයිමයි but there will be no thrice හැබැයි දරුවනේ තුන්වෙනි පාරක් නෑ why for then I find all shut on me තුන්වෙනි දවසේ මම යනකොට for the third time when I visit the place visit the same house he finds that doors shut on me දොරවල් මට වහිලා right doors shut on me so then is that the genuineness of people who they ekada real welcoming is taker gedarakata awahama palaweni deweni para enawa kiyenawa ne e widira salakanawa habai thunweni para enakota enawa peni peni dorawahanawa So then, what is the use of that kind of flowery words they uttered earlier at the very beginning, at the very first time, and also the second time? So, isn't it any other thing rather than the hypocrisy of people, dear children? That duality. So, all those words they uttered earlier have been destroyed when it comes to the thrice third day of visiting, right? So that means if he visits someone very often, he is no longer welcomed. Nithara nithara, ekaale hemane vele daruvan. Neda. Now let's look back to our own past. මේ ඇග්‍රිකල්චරල් බේස් එකක් තිබිච්ච අපේ අතීතෙට ගිහිලා බලන්න. කුඹුරු වල හේන් වල වැඩ නැති කාලෙට. So the people in the village, they go for visiting. They pay the visits, paying calls for the people who are in the neighborhood. එහෙම එනකොට දොරක් වහලා තියෙනකොට එන්න කියලා අනේ එන්න හෙටත් එන්න කියලා එනවා පෙනිපෙනි දොර වහනක් පුටුවද what kind of insult that the man will get, right? එක මහා නින්දාවක් නේ, right? So that actually indicates that repeated visits are openly rejected. So you know that find opening doors that suggest us that having opportunities for interaction and all. Dorak karinawa kiyanakota puthe eka symbolic neda, which suggests that opportunities are open for socialization, for interaction, to bond with the others and all. But closing a door means that all those interactive avenues are closed and rejected, denied openly. Peni peni dora wahana kota ara association interaction ekata thibechi chances tika puthe opportunities tika okkoma block karala ne tiyenne de ehema katha sirith issara kale thibune na, right? Can you see this picture? I told you earlier also, Gabriel O'Hara is a Nigerian poet, right? So then, can you see the happiness of these two people, right? These two black-skinned man and the woman, they are true-heartedly laughing at them. But here, can you see the looks of these white people? So that's what the poet wants to show us. So these blacks, these natives, they are really heartiestly talking. So can you see the eye contacts here? And with this woman also. So actually they are genuinely laughing. But here, although there are some things at hands, can you see any kind of happiness from these two? මේ මනුස්ස මේ ලේඩිගෙන් සහ මේ මනුස්සයාගේ මූණු වලින් මේ තරම් සතුටක් දැනෙනවද? මේ තරම් ඉපිලෙන සතුටක්. I mean extreme happiness. Right? Can you see? No. That is the problem. So the door shut on me. That indicates, that suggests, that symbolizes that all the avenues for interaction and all the opportunities for, all the opportunities to be bound have been closed and blocked, right? The next stanza. So I have learned many things. Puthe attarama hitala balanda me swabhavaya nemeida puthe api me ada gatha karanne. That is the bitter reality, right? That is the true experiences that we are undergoing. අපිට එහෙම chances නැද්ද දරුවනේ නේද? තමන්ගේ හිත කැමතිම relation කෙනෙක් ගෙදරට එනකොට දවස් ගානක් ඉඳලා ගෙවල් ලස් කරලා අතුපතු ගහලා කෑම බීම හදලා menus හදලා යන්නේ කොහෙද කියලා plan කරලා ඔක්කොම කරනවා. But if, just imagine that when you find that the most unwelcome relative is visiting tomorrow, එතකොට අපිට දාහක් නැති වැඩම ඇවෙනවා. හෙට කොයි හරි යන්න දාගත්ත එක හෙට දවසේ ඉඳලා online classes ටිකම ඇවෙනවා. Why is that? What is the reason behind? Because you do not like that man. හැබැයි දරුවනේ දැන් එහෙමයි කියලා ආවහම අපෝ මම ඔයගොල්ලොත් එක්ක කතා කරන්න නැහැ කියලා කාමරය හැසිරලා ඉන්න පුළුවන් අපිට. You just think about this incident seriously, my dear children. අපිට එහෙම ඉන්න බෑනේ. අනේ ඉතින් එන අම්මගේ බලකිරීමට හරි අපි එළියට එනවා. අනේ කොහොමද ඉතින් උඟ කාලෙකින් දැක්කේ ඇයි අනේ මේ පැත්තේවත් ආවෙ නැත්තේ? Those are the things we utter. So isn't that the hypocrisy of modern people? Isn't that the hypocrisy and the duality played by the people in the modern era? අපි කැමති නැහැ කියලා දරුවනේ අපිට බැහැනේ. Avoid කරන්න පුළුවන්ද? No, we can't. We can't just throw them out. So we have to deal with them. We have to work with them. We have to talk with them. But that is not with the true-hearted feeling.
ಸೊ ಕಲ್ಚರಲ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಏನೋ ದರೂನಿ ಜನರೇಷನ್ಸ್ ದೆಕ್ಕೇಕ್ ಸೊಸೈಟೀಸ್ ದೆಕ್ಕೇಕ್ ದ ಫಾದರ್ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ದ ಪಾಸ್ಟ್ ಜನರೇಷನ್ಸ್ ವೈಲ್ ದ ಸನ್ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ದ ಮಾಡರ್ನ್ ಜನರೇಷನ್ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಕಲ್ಚರಲ್ ಶಿಫ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ ಹೂ ಈಸ್ ಅನೇಬಲ್ ಟು ಟಾಲರೇಟ್ ದಟ್ ಕಲ್ಚರಲ್ ಶಿಫ್ಟ್ ಅಪಿಟ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ವೆಂಡ ವೆನವ ದರೂನಿ We can't avoid that. It's unavoidable. Transformation should be happened. Of course, yes. But the thing is, when that kind of transformation happens, it happens in a total negative way. Apethi bichu honda kampute adha api hitala balanda atite pochchara calm and quiet, serene and healthy life ekak api gatha karada. Which was environment friendly actually. Although we know that at present, All these things we have done, we are doing, are fake and spoiled and everything. But can we go back to that serene past once again? Kanne bonne honda nathi de dannawa. Right? We are always eating, having junk food and all. Breathing poisonous gases and all. Right? But can we go back to the past? Leaving all these comforts and all? So that is one of the themes it's, the poet deals with. Adaptation. Adaptation, Vendona. We have to be flexible enough. We can't be rigid to those kind of transformations and changes. But the thing is, we have to be very conscious regarding that. උදේ අපි කලින් කියපු stanza එකේ තුන්වෙනි visit එක යන්නේ he this father is totally deceived and driven by the flowery words They uttered at the very beginning. Tumvini visit me manusyo gana mehemai me manusyo mehema dual they are playing the dual roles and that they are really hypocritical kila danagena hitiya nange he never visits such kind of third visit. Tumvini visit ekak yanne neha. That is the problem. We have to adapt. Tika kalaya koi vidihata hala happy world ekathu vela puthe me taata igena gannawa. So I have learned many things. මේ සමාජයේ ජීවත් වෙන්න වෙනවනේ we have to survive in the society so we have to do adaptations මේ සමාලාට ආච්චිලා කියන ඇතනේ අපේ කාලේ නම් ඔය වගේ කොටට ගවුම් ඇඳේ නැහැ කියනවා ඇතේ නේද අපේ කාලේ නම් ගෑනු ළමයි especially for the girls I mean ගෑනු ළමයි ওই විදිහට හයියෙන් කෑක ගහ hina උනේ නැහැ අපේ කාලේ නම් පිරිමි ළමයි හැන්දාවේ කලවර වැටෙන්න කලින් කොහේ ගියත් ගෙදර ආවා Don't you hear such kind of utterings from your family background? එහෙම ඇහෙන්නේ නැද්ද? සමහරවිට ඕගොල්ලන්ට හිතෙන අපෝ අපේ අම්මයි තාත්තයිවත් මට මොකුත් කියන්නේ ආච්චිට නෙමෙයි අමාරුව. එහමයි කරේ. එහෙම හිතනවා නේද? Why is that? Because that ආච්චි අම්මා or this granny she has been torn between these two cultures. That She is not in a position to tolerate that cultural shift. Ai amma taatta e prashna walata monawath nokiyanne because your mother and father also belong to this present society. Unlike your grandmother. They have not experienced them. Your mother and father have not experienced the serenity and the genuineness of the past. So they are almost all living in this society. So for Everything is same for them, but not for the grandmother. So that thing has already happened with this father also, right? Me ha patra visvevi ekek neida hitridavi mevil puthe me a therum ganna. If I want to survive, if I want to live in this kind of society, I also want to adapt. So then he has learned many things. I have learned to wear many faces like dresses. මට බොරුව පෙන්වන්න බැරි නම් ඒ ප්‍රතිපත්තිය පුතේ හැමතැනම තියෙන්න එපේ. මට බොරුව පෙන්වන්න බැරි දුප්පත් මිනිස්සුත් එක්ක විතර නම් is it a policy of mine? Is there any kind of validity? No. මට බොරුව පෙන්වන්න බෑ පොඩි මිනිස්සුත් එක්ක දුප්පත් මිනිස්සු එක්ක. But it's okay when it comes to the affluent people. Am I a genuine person? එහෙමනම් මම genuine person කෙනෙක්ද? No. But here in this society dear children we have to adjust according to the situation. ඒ මගේ ප්‍රතිපත්ති වලින් වැඩක් නැහැ මට වඩා බොහොම පවර්ෆුල් ෆිගර් එකක් ඉස්සරහ කතා කරද්දී මම නිකන් චූටි මිනිස්සෙක් විතරයි අර පොඩි පොඩි මිනිස්සු ඉස්සරහ මම දාන ලොකු ටෝක් අපි කතාවට කිව්වෝ ඒව වැඩක් වෙන්නේ නැහැ පුතේ so then we have to be adjusted we have to adapt according to the situation so then this father also learned to wear many faces like dresses of course right home face ගෙදරට එක mood එකක් office face එක street face host face cocktail face with all their conforming smiles what do you mean by the word conforming dear children that is normally acceptable ඕන කෙනෙක්ට accept කරනවා obeying කියන එකයි ඕන හා හරි office එකේ මොනා හරි හා හරියන් අර පාරේ හම්බෙන කෙනා හරි මාත් එකගයි හැබැයි හදවතේ තියෙන පුතේ මේ මිනිසුන්ගේ දේවල් වලට 100ක් එකඟ වීම නෙමෙයි වැරදි කියලා දැනෙනව නමුත් ඔබේ වෙනවා conforming smiles ඒ මොකද ආගිව් කරලා වැඩක් නැහැ ඕනෙයකට හා කියා ගන්න විදිහට ඉන්නවා හරියට like a fixed portrait smile අර පුතේ රාමු කරපු ෆොටෝග්‍රාෆ් එක තියෙන හිනාව අපිට වෙනස් කරන්න බෑනේ ඒ හිනාව අපිට කවදාවත් වෙනස් කරන්න බෑ අන්න ඒ වගේ තමයි පුතේ ඕන කෙනෙක් බැලුවාම හැමෝටම ප්ලීසින්ග් වෙන ස්මයිල් එකක් දාගෙන හිටපම මම සේෆ් හැබැයි where is that true hearted man inside this person අර හදවතට එකඟව වැඩ කරන ජෙනුයින් මෑන් කෝ that original man no it's gone නෑ දැන් ඉන්නේ තනිකරම ෆේක් ෆිගර් එකක් විතරයි හැම දෙයකම එහෙයි කියාගෙන ඔළුව වනන හරි ඇඳුම් මාරු කරනවා වගේ පුතේ ඔකේෂන් එකකින් ඔකේෂන් එකට ඉන්න පුද්ගලයන්ගේ හැටියට මූඩ් එක චේන්ජ් කරන මම වෙනස් වෙන ලොකු පිරිසක් ඉස්සරහා කතා කරනකොට මම නිකම් උකුත් දන්නේ වගේ ඉන්න මිනිස්සේ හැබැයි මට වඩා උගත්කමින් අඩු පිරිසක් එක කතා කරන මම තමයි වීරයා හැබැයි මේ වීරය එහෙම් පිටීම තියලා බලන්න ඕන අර වගේ උගත් සමාජයක උලම් බහැපු බැලුමක් වගේ so in likewise this father also had learned to wear many faces according to the situation that means he adjusted himself to suit the different types of situations right he the father has learned to wear many faces means he has learned to act or behave according to the need of each situation and not according to his own natural feeling tamange natural feeling ekata neme emotion ekata neve puthe weda kare harida ara situation ekata kaatath galapena vidihata thamai weda kare ehema baane genuine personality ekak unawa tamange status taman thiyak ganna ona taman edire inne kawuru unath apita wadanne so that is called the genuineness but that kind of genuineness is not validated within this kind of hypocritical society හැමෝම එකම දිශාවකට ගමන් කරනකොට මට විතරක් අනිත් පැත්තට ගමන් කිරීම තේරුමක් නැහැ useless නේ ඒ වගේ දෙයක් කරන්න පුළුවන්ද most religious people like lord buddha and the jesus and all right being these kind of ordinary people we cannot do that such things so we also remain like as hypocritical creatures in the modern society because we cannot change it with anything so these are the moods right moods minisunge moods change wenawa pote ekama mood ekata randenna ba ugalata puluwanda happy mood ekak ude patan gattu welawa indan inda puluwanda ugalata taraha enna nadda ugalata dukha hitenna nadda adu gana badagine wenakota epa wenakota kata hambarenna nadda right can we stay in the same mood for a long time for the whole lifetime no we cannot habai ithin ehema ninda wela thiyenne kaatath galapena widihata etakota thamai api honda eyata thondai meyata thondai habai api true hearted nevey etana we don't show off the natural feelings right so these different phases stand for the different ways in which a person conducts himself to behave in order to make match the situation sir situation ekata match wala herana vidiyata puthe mamath igena gatta kiyala kinawa that is the adaptation of this father into the modern society right? And I have learned too. තවත් ඉගෙන ගත්ත තවත් adaptive behavior එකක් ගැන කියන්න යන්නේ. And I have learned too. මම මොනවද තව ඉගෙන ගත්තේ? So I have put numbers here to make it easy to introduce you. තව ඉගෙන ගත්ත දේවල් මොනවද? Right? So I have learned to laugh with only my teeth. Genuineness කියන එක frankness කියන එක honesty කියන එක true heartedness කියන එක පුතේ මං එලෙව්වා පැත්තක දාලා මමත් ඉගෙන ගත්තා හේ කියලා නිකන් අර laughter plastic කිනව that artificial laughter කෝකටත් තයිලේ වගේ අන්න එහෙම hina වෙන්න මං ඉගෙන ගත්තා right and shake hands without my hands කවුද මට වැඩන්නේ किसीम जेनुइन फीलिंग ने कहा तू ओहे करान्नंग वाले मैकेनिकल वे कक विधिहट शेक हैंड करान्न मांगेगे नगत्ता राइट नंबर थ्री आई आल्सो हैव लर्न टू से गुड बाय व्हेन आई मीन गुड रिडन्स सो व्हाट इज इट डियर चिल्ड्रन गुड बाय एंड गुड रिडन्स आई थिंक यू मे नो अबाउट दिस गुड बाय बट आई एम नॉट क्वाइट श्योर वेदर यू नो इट प्रॉपरली गुड बाय आप बाय කියලා කියන්නේ එකත් වැරදි එකත් කි Goodbye කියලා කියන්නේ use it. So the term goodbye is used to express good wishes when parting. Parting separate වෙනකොට හමු වීමක් අවසානයේ වෙන් වෙලා යනකොට goodbye කියලා කියන්නේ නැවත ඔබ හමු වන තුරු කරදරයක් වෙන්න එපා. That is the idea behind the word goodbye. ආයේ අපි හෙට හමු වෙනවා යාළුවෝට bye කියලා යන්නේ goodbye කියන්නේ පුතේ. It should be goodbye. Right? එහෙම යන්නේ ආයේ ඔබ මට හමු වන තුරු. So there is a kind of expectation of meeting again in this word goodbye. But when it comes to the good riddance, what do you mean by good riddance? මොකද්ද good riddance කියලා කියන්නේ පුතේ? අයියෝ යනවට thank you හැබැයි ආයේ නම් එන්න එපා වගේ අදහසක්. Right? Number 4 to say glad to see you without being glad ane oyawa dakkahama kochchera satutuda mata de api kiyanne deviya budun dakka wage tamai oyawa dakkahama habai hita athule thiyena idea eka apu adath awada adath me manusyawada mata moonatama hamba wenne ayyo dawasama iwarai kiyala hita gena kiyano ane oyawa satutu yane mamme bala bala hitiya oyawa hamba weida naddha kiyana that kind of thing So that is the duality of these people. That is the hypocrisy of these people. එහෙමනේ වේද දරුවනේ හිතේ එකක් තියාගෙන තව දෙයක් කතා කිරීම සහ ක්‍රියා කිරීම isn't that hypocrisy? Right? And to say it's been nice talking to you after being bored. අයියෝ මේ කතාව දැන්වත් ඉවරයක් වෙන්නේ නැද්ද මල වදයක් මල කරදරේ මට වෙන වැඩක් කරගන්නත් නැහැ කියලා හිත හිත අනේ ඔයත් එක කතා කර කර ඉඳ තියෙනවනේ මට කොච්චර සතුටුද අනේ මං හරි කැමතියි ඔයත් එක කතා කර කර ඉන්න කියලා කියන That is the way of modern society my dear children as දෙක අරලාවට ලෝකය දිහා බැලුවොත් මේ සිද්ධවීම රිපීට් වෙවි පුතේ අපිට දකින්න පුළුවන් ඔය කතා කරන අට කරන වර්ඩ්ස් වල තියෙන අර්ථය ඒ විදිහටම ට්‍රූ හාටඩ්ද කියලා අපිට හොයන්න බැරි එක තමයි තියෙන ප්‍රශ්නේ පුතේ so we definitely we go by the appearance and the flowery words and honeyed words of the people but it takes time for us to know that come to know That we have been deceived. මේ විදිහේ වචන පාවිච්චි කර goodbye කියන්නේ අනේ ආයේ එන්න අපි ආයේ හම්බ වෙනකන් ඔයා පරිස්සමින් ඉන්න. Good riddance කියන්නේ අනේ අම්බෝ යන්න පින් සිද්ධ වෙ යන්න ලොකු දෙයක්. Thank you. හැබැයි ආයේ නම් මට නම් ඔයාව හම්බ වෙන්නවත් එපා. This is another picture. I have also learned to say goodbye when I mean good riddance. Can you see the facial expressions and the gestures of these two? Here she smiles heartiestly it seems and here just a fake smile he has worn just a fake smile on the face right Good riddance. Goodbye and good riddance. Good riddance, can you just read these things? Good riddance is used when you have negative feelings towards a person and you don't want to see them ever again. Aay na jeevithayata amba wenna paakilla hite thiyagena ane goodbye. Goodbye kiyana eke theruma dannathu ena. Right, it's blessing, it's having blessers and wishes when parting, and it's a wish, there lies a wish to have protection and all until we meet again, until we meet the next day. But good riddance indicates that totally indicates a totally negative idea regarding the person, and he never expects to meet him again. ආය කවදාවත් ජීවිතේ හම්බ වෙන්න එපා කියලා ප්‍රාර්ථනා කරන එක තමයි good riddance කියලා කියන්නේ. Right. So what are these pictures? So this is the reality of the modern man. He's running after many many more things. He's handling much more things simultaneously. But then this man finds no time to take care about the others around. Right, so we are running in a very busy track and running after something or other, and we don't find a little time even to dedicate on behalf of the other person. So can you see, dear children, they are running after time and money and all. So do you see, it's completely a havoc. So they all are really in a hurry. It's like some ferocious animals are chasing them. Right? Bayanaka sattu tikak pidipassen pannagena ena wage neida? It's the time that the chasing. These people, men and women. Right? They don't have time to see whether there are people around me. Man wadeta manusya thawa innawada kiyala hithala balanna. Just to have a concern on others. No, they don't have time. So they all are in a hurry. But they don't know why they are in a hurry and what for. Nothing. Right. But believe me, son. Namuth mama vishwasa karanna putha. I want to be what I used to be. Mata vendona. මම හිටපු විදිහට මට වෙන්න ඕනේ. When I was like you, මං ඔයා වගේ කාලේ ජීවත් වෙච්ච විදිහට මට ජීවත් වෙන්න ඕන. I want to unlearn all these muting things. Unlearn muting things. Unlearn කියලා කියන්නේ පුතේ prefix එකක් පාවිච්චි කරලා තියෙන වචනයක්. Learn and unlearn. Learn ඉගෙන ගන්නවා, unlearn කියන්නේ ඉගෙනගත්තු දේ අත්හරින්න ඕනේ. All this muting, what do you mean by the word muting? Muting in the sense emotionless, right? Feelingless, kisi me emotion ekak nathi, feeling ekak nathi, expression ekak nathi. His, right? Attarama kiwoth empty, me learning swelling mata midendona. I want to unlearn all these muting things. Most of all, I want to relearn how to laugh. Vaddi purama mage taruwane මට ඕනේ ඉගෙන ගන්න how to laugh. ආයි මට ඉගෙන ගත්තා unlearn කරලා. Earlier he told I also have learned කියලා ඉගෙන ගත්ත දේවල් ටිකක් කිව්වනේ. මේ කුහක සමාජයේ hypocritical society එක ඇතුලේ ජීවත් වෙන්න මම ඉගෙන ගත්ත දේවල්. දැන් මට ඒ ඔක්කොම අයින් කරන්න ඕන. හැබැයි මට ඉගෙන ගන්න ඕන. I want to relearn. නැවත ඉගෙන ගන්න ඕනේ. How to laugh. Hina wenne kohomada kiyala. For my laugh in the mirror. Mam me hina wenna hina wimen kannadiyekin baluwoth ehema penenne koi wageda dannawada puthe. Shows only my teeth like a snake's fangs. Ara snakes la sarpayo vishadala virittagena like this. Oh my goodness. ඔය තියෙන විෂදාල poisonous teeth තියෙන ඔය විෂදාල නේද පෙන්නගෙන කට අරගෙන ගොදුරකට පනින්න බලාගෙන ඉන්න සර්ප විෂ ගෝර සර්පයේගේ මූණක් තමයි හිනාවක් තමයි පුතේ අද මම මේ ලහිනාව කන්නඩේකින් බැලුවොත් පේන්නේ that laughter is totally poisonous. It's really harmful for others. Right? No genuine feeling is there. No protection is there. No caring and sharing aspect is there. But just only it's poisonous. Right? So, mage hinawa ada pute visa hinawak tiyenne. Right? I can't true-heartedly welcome the other people. අනිත් මිනිසුන්ව අවංකවම හිතට එකඟවම වෙල්කම් කරන්න මට බෑ. මගේ කුරුරුකම මගේ ඩුවැලිටි කියන එක හිපොක්‍රසි කියන එක it may be out shown එළියට පෙනෙනවා ඇති. මට දැනෙන හැටියට නම් ඔය විස කරුහිනා උච්චරම තමයි. So can you see the father although he shows a smiley face to the world what is he inside? අර එතනින් එහා පසුතලයේ තියෙන කවුරුද කා ගැනද මේ කතා කරන්න කියලා අහනවා right so show me son අනේ ඉතින් මට පෙන්වන්න පුතේ how to laugh show me how I used to laugh and smile once upon a time when I was like you අනේ පුතේ මට පෙන්වන්න teach me once again how to laugh and show me how you I used to laugh And smile. Ani mama hina unni komad kila mata penna andu bolu ande. Once upon a time when I was like you. Ekka matte ka kaalika. Mama oyalatte hitiya vage. Ekka matte ka kaalika mama hitiya vage. Bohoma sonduru lesa sundara lesa hina venna mata ugannanda. Please teach me and show me son and please direct me how to laugh genuinely. That is the request of this elderly father. He begs from the young son because it's we know that the most pure smile is with the children. They don't have any kind of negative impressions like jealousy, hypocrisy and all. So they have the purest smile. So that's why the father begs from request from the son to teach him what to teach him the genuine smile right so he comes to a circular end where he started and here again he mentions the same point at the last point also in the poem right Earlier stanza at the very beginning also he refers to the smile and the laughter which is fake and genuine in the two societies and here again he comes to that laughter and requests and begs the son to teach him the best smile the natural smile he had right So the poet it seems that poet bitterly regrets and wishes to return to the early and sincere nature. Can you see the smiles and laughters of these young students, young children, dear children? Right? Can you see this happiness they reflect on their faces? A moon wala ittirena satuta, the overflowing happiness they have. So they have the pure smile with them. And in this picture also, right here, this elderly man heads back to the past while this young man heads in front. That means while the son goes to the future, the father wants to go to the past. Just because he had already experienced the genuineness of the past era as because the son is not totally aware and he is totally unaware about that kind of genuineness he goes on to the future with all these negative impressions and ideas right okay we have discussed the poem so far And dear children, let's go for the themes. appearance is not always the reality. The father has been deceived by that kind of flowery words, and they are show off actually. Get the rain, feel at home, come again, they say, right? Misleading. So it surely deals with appearances, not always the reality. Next one, adaptation to the ways of life. Api katha kara pute. Even this father also learned to wear many faces, and he had learned 5 things together which the society taught him through experience. So that adaptation to the new way of life. Api tatte ma siddha vei pute. You definitely in one's life, you have to adapt to such kind of situations a number of times. When you go abroad, right? When you go for higher studies, and when you happen to stay there with your new friends and all, right? When you happen to go abroad and settle down there. When it comes to especially the marriage system, of course, that you have to adapt to that situation. Why not? For sure. You can't avoid. But the thing is, you have to be alert on the people's appearance and all. Third one, innocent childhood versus adulthood. You may find number of evidences to prove that point, prove that theme, and change that comes through exposure to the other cultures. Anit cultures walata exposed wenakota in a change. So we have to be tolerant. We have to tolerate such kind of changes, but without destroying the true self of you. Avanka tamanthula inna avanka manusya vinasha karagena nevey puthe adaptation wenno me. E change ekata face karanna one. But with all of your good qualities and all. ලොකු මිනිහෙක් වුණාට වැඩක් නැහැ දරුවනේ. හොඳයි කියන qualities ඔක්කොම විසි කරලා දාලා. අද අපි දකින්නේ lacking එක එක තමයි. So let's move on to the techniques. Number 1, we have discussed all these techniques, I think. Dramatic monologue. Though we seem that the father is addressing the son remains muted always. පුතා mute වෙලා නින්නේ. Hence this comes a monologue. ඒ නිසා මේක මොනොලොග් එකක් බවට පත් වෙනවා. Comparisons and contrasts. The childhood of the father is similar to the son. Of course, yes. Father compares his earlier innocence to that of his sons. Right? Fatherගේ childhood එකයි son's childhood එකයි පුතේ මෙතන compare කරනවා. Right? He contrasts his present way of behavior to the past, drawing out many examples through experiences. Of course, yes, we have seen it. Number 3, similes. So these are the similes. These are the examples for the similes I have given. And metaphor. Ice block cold ice is the example. Sarcasm. Feel at home, come again, for then I find door shut on me. So these are the example. Of course, it's really sarcastic. Feel at home and come again. It's really sarcastic. Irony. I have learned to say goodbye when I mean good riddance. Saying opposite of what is meant. Kiyanda tiyana de opposite ekak katha kirima thamai irony kiyala kiyanne. Use of coined words. Coined words tiyena puthe. Home face, office face, street face. And this enjambment, run on lines kiyala kiyana daruwane. What is it? I hope you know that. Puthe, ekka thought ekak, ekka line ekekin iwara naha. It goes to the second one. And the second thought begins from the second line, and it goes to the third one. And the third begins in the fourth one. Likewise, ara ekak line ekak iwara weddi puthe ekak idea ekak thought ekak situvillak iwara naha. Eka ilanga rule ekata panina. right anna ek here I feel at home come again they say that they say line should be here which I miss and repetition the word sun and laugh are repeated several times and also there are some more phrases repeated here the smile the word smile also repeated right I have learned right okay those there are some more instances that you can see the repetitions symbols I told you I have discussed this in the during the discussion for then I find doors shut on me opening of doors symbolizes having opportunities for social interactions and relationships but here the close of doors symbolizes ceasing all human interactions right so closing the doors as a symbol right shall we have a look on the past paper questions right for the extractions first okay this is the only extraction we meet since 2016 that is given in 2018 I have learned to wear many faces like dresses home face office face street face host face right a name the word that carries these lines name the writer repeatedly I have told you I have introduced you I have informed you how to answer this A question so you have to be very much careful and very much conscious of the title and you have to pay attention for each and every word and the punctuation mark of the title and also you have to pay attention to the capitalization that means you have to produce the title and also the name of the poet or the writer as it is given to you I hope you got my point so this must be the answer once upon a time by Gabriel Locara see whether I am correct right b what life experience does the speaker refer to in these lines what life experience does the speaker refer to in these lines me lines walin eyage jeevithe mona vidhi experience ekak ganada me kiyanne so that is the pretentious or fake behavior of people and the adaptation to different puthe fake behavior ekak tama habai eka vitarak ba because here the line mentions I have learned mama igena gena thiyenawa kiyala ne kiyanne mama igena gatta samajaye that is the adaptation so I think you need to write both the ideas pretentious or fake behavior of people and the adaptation to different changes is referred here right c you know that so far we got a b c parts only right from this year onwards you get d what is the effect created by the images the poet uses puthe effect ekak kiyana ekak hawwot right what is the idea that the poet wants to create in the reader's minds by writing this kind of line by writing by using this kind of device or whatever so what is the idea of the poet to create in our minds puthe ape hite me readers lage hadawate mona vidihe feeling ekak mona vidihe deyak athi karanda da meya me line ekak liyanne right we have to concern on ourselves right consciousness of human hypocrisy practices of opportunism with sarcasm and ironical attitude actually ap readers la vidiyata apita danenno ona meya me line ekak kiyaddi api we have to be alert on this human hypocrisy kiyeneka that's what sorry I told you earlier also my dear children walata man kalin kiyuweth ekai we can't avoid such kind of occasions in life we can't just ignore and throw away the hypocritical people we have to associate them so nearly or so distantly we have to do we can't avoid but we have to be alert and conscious enough to see their hypocrisy to identify their hypocritical values and all right Okay. Next, I have the past paper questions on critical questions. 2017. This is the question given. Gabriel Okara shows how socio-cultural changes affect people's behavior. Kohomada? Social culture shows how socio-cultural changes affect people's behavior. Manusege behavior ekata pute. Kohomada me socio-cultural changes affect venne kiyala ahana. Right? Kohomada? There are two parts of this question actually. Kotas dekak thiyena daruwane. One is the identification of socio-cultural experiences. Uthe socio-cultural experiences emanatthan changes oyamme kathule thiyenawa pennanawa kiyala api kiyanna ona. And the other part is how they have affected people's lives. E socio-cultural changes kohomada manussayage jeevithayata balapanne. So it's an easy question, right? So identification, under the identification of social changes, so like these social practices like handshaking, communication, smiling, welcoming people, searching for status, me wage deval tamai puthe change vela thiyenne kiyala pennanna ona api. You can do it using the evidence. And how they affected people's lives kiyuwama, right? Their customs, e jeevithayata puthe eyalage customs walata practices and behavior patterns, and they have to be transformed. So these are some of the quotations, right? But now they laugh only with their teeth. I have learned to wear many faces like dresses, right? The speakers urge, and also you, this is a very good point, my dear children. The speakers urge to go back to past. Me nostalgic feeling neka. I want to go back to the past kind of strong idea eka. Also indicate that he is not happy with these transformations. May transformations ekka have satutu nahai kiyanne ekaka hetuwa, which means that socio cultural changes have affected the people negatively. Me samaje inda bari nisana epa vela nisana puthe fed up hindane ya apahu mate ugannanda puthe kiyala kiyanne. I want to unlearn all these muting things. I want to relearn how to laugh and all. Right. This is the 2019 question. Gabriel Okara's Once Upon a Time is a depiction of people's pretense and hypocrisy. Again, it's also an easy question. Pretense and hypocrisy. Anivara. Ekane api mechara katha karanne. Right? These are some of the points. Poem dramatically presents an adult's reflection of his past. Right? He is a man who is torn between two cultures. You can prove these things. The poem is an outspoken, honest description of the speaker's both sincere and insincere actions. Yes. He seems to justify that his current hypocritical behavior, stating that it is caused through social influences. The poem is presented as a comparison between past and present. The past seems genuine and sincere in comparison to the present, and the present society is insincere, money oriented, selfish and dual, and also hypocritical. So don't worry, dear children, there's no any rule, I mean no need of dictating all these things, and you can creatively prove your idea. So now you know the meaning and you know the idea of the poet and the poem, and in the mechanical terms, themes and the techniques also we have found. So then no, nothing to worry about this. You just get the juice of the question. You get the gist of the question here. Depictions of people's pretense and hypocrisy. There are ample evidences in the question. So these are some of the evidences. Feel at home, come again, there will be no thrice, for then I find those shut on me, right? I have also learned to say goodbye and God riddance, the five things he has learned from the society. from the hypocritical society that the description must be very much strong and logical enough. My dear children, if you want to get a good mark, right? For my laugh in the mirror shows only my teeth like a snake's bare fangs. A very good evidence to prove the hypocrisy, right? So with that, we have come to the end of our session today. I hope you are well aware about the poem Once Upon a Time by Gabriel O'Hara, and read it many times and find and get the idea of the poem and the questions, and write down the questions, answer them, and do not go on copying down any other's ideas. You can just reveal your inner mind. If you are capable with your language, that is enough. Right? Okay, dear children. Hope to meet you in another session of literature, and thank you very much. And my thanks goes to the Zonal Education Office, Chilaung, also. And thank you, dear sirs and madams. And thank you very much, dear children. And we always believe that you are taking the benefits from our efforts. Thank you very much, and have a nice day.